Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon. Sit down. Chandra Prakash.
Thank you, ma'am.
You can remove your shield and the mask.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
नेशनल डिफेंस एकेडमी की सफल तैयारी सेंचुरियन डिफेंस एकेडमी के साथ पाएं ऑफलाइन व ऑनलाइन कोर्सेज के तहत गाइडेंस रेगुलर क्लासेस फ्री स्टडी मटेरियल वीकली मॉक टेस्ट स्पोकन एंड पर्सनालिटी डेवलपमेंट सेशंस डाउट क्लियरिंग सेशंस सेंचुरियन डिफेंस एकेडमी स्टूडेंट ऐप का एक्सेस एवं फ्री व इंडिविजुअलाइज्ड एसएसबी गाइडेंस और फीडबैक और हिस्सा बने हमारी अनवरत चली आ रही कामयाबी की दास्तां का
Chandra Prakash, where are you coming from?
I'm going from Lucknow, ma'am.
From Lucknow?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, which place?
Ekta Nagar in Lucknow, ma'am.
Okay. Today, what you had in your breakfast and in your lunch?
In my breakfast, I had sandwich. Mm-hmm. And in my lunch, ma'am, I had ravage, dal and chapati. Okay. And also rice, ma'am.
Tell me something about your family, because you belong to a civilian background. So how come Rashtriya Indian Military College, RIMC, how come RIMC? Yes.
Firstly, my family consists of four members including me. Firstly, my father, he is working as a lower division assistant at SGPJMS Lucknow. My mother, she is a homemaker. And my sister, she is currently pursuing BSc Nursing from SGPJMS Lucknow. And sir, and ma'am, I got inspiration about RMC through one of my relatives who had served in the army.
Okay.
He had told me about it. And thereafter, I went through it on the internet and I got more interested towards the armed forces. So thereafter, I decided to join RMC and I gave exam. And thereafter, I joined RMC. Yes, ma'am. That's all.
That's good. So what changes you see in yourself as Chandra Prakash Yadav then and now after completing your education from RIMC?
Yes, ma'am. After completing my education from RIMC, there are two major changes which I see, ma'am. Uh-huh. Firstly, after spending 5 years out there, today now I feel that I have become a more confident boy from what I was once I joined RIMC. Second, ma'am, also the physical fitness. Once I joined, I was not that much physically fit, but now, after spending time out there, I am comfortable with my physical fitness and I am also able to maintain it. And these are the two major changes which RMC has brought in.
Good. Okay. So I can see in your PRQ that you were not recommended in your previous SSP when you cleared your NDA.
Yes, ma'am.
So, what was the main reason and now what you did to clear your SSP to get the recommendation? Yes.
Ma'am, in my view, there were two main reasons because of which I was not able to get recommended in the last attempt. Mm-hmm. Firstly, ma'am, because of my handwriting speed, which had hampered me, which had caused a problem while I was completing the psychological test. And also, at that point of time, I did not have that much fluency while I was speaking. So, I feel that these were the two reasons. And so, I have adequately worked on it, like I had done practice in front of a mirror. And also, I got engaged in more public speaking lectures so that I can improve my fluency. And talking about my handwriting speed, I made it a point that whenever I am studying any topic, let it be relating to my group discussion or whether I am practicing psychology, I made sure that I write it down so that it helped me to improve my handwriting and also increase my speed. And apart from that, I also took guidance from my batchmates and seniors who had got recommended, and I took feedback from them, and also I took guidance from a coaching in Lucknow to keep in touch with the process of the so that I can do the group discussions and lectures in a group. And I went through online sources for reading the geopolitics topics, and that's how I prepared for this attempt, ma'am.
Good. Okay, so the next question is going to be the interesting question.
Yes,
supposing
ma'am.
You are standing on the surface of the earth and you walk 1 mile south, 1 mile west, 1 mile north, you end up exactly where you started. Can you tell me where are you? Okay, shall I repeat the question?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So you are standing on the surface of the earth.
Yes, ma'am.
Somewhere. You walk 1 mile, 1 mile south, 1 mile west, and 1 mile north. You end up exactly where you started.
Yes, ma'am.
Where are you? Any idea? Any guess? You can. Yes.
Ma'am, if you're asking in terms of geographical location.
Exactly, geographical location.
Ma'am,
which direction?
I'll be facing the
yes.
north, ma'am.
You'll be facing the north.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so coming to the next question. What is your greatest fear?
Ma'am, my greatest fear in my view would be to lose the trust of the people who believe in me, ma'am.
Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. How many friends you have? And how many are your close friends? And what your friends think about you? And tell me one aspect of your personality they dislike.
Ma'am, my friend circle consists of around 30 to 40 friends. Firstly, because we are a batch of 30, so those are my close friends. And apart from that, I have my school friends in Lucknow. And also, I had made friends in my previous SSB. And also, I'm also in contact with some of my seniors and juniors.
Mm-hmm.
And talking about the friends who are close to me, my coursemates, Rest 29, they are very close to me, ma'am. And we all enjoy being together. And in my personality, there is nothing they dislike in me. But one thing which they do not like is my non-humorous jokes, ma'am. Sometimes whenever we are together, sometimes they enjoy it, ma'am. And it has become a part whenever we are together.
Okay. I would like to know, how do you deal with criticism and feedback?
Ma'am, whenever I face any criticism,
mm-hmm.
Firstly I analyze whether whatever I am being criticized on is true, ma'am. And then after analyzing, I see, ma'am, whether I have to work on it or not. And ma'am, I believe in my capabilities. And if I have to work on it, I gracefully accept my mistake. Thereafter, I work on it. And if not so, ma'am, then I believe in myself and I continue to move towards my aim.
Okay. Can you tell me what is the difference between hard work and smart work?
Ma'am, I feel that hard work and smart work, they're something which go together, ma'am. For becoming a smart working person, firstly, hard work is something which is required, ma'am. Like for example, if an athlete, ma'am, if he has to reach the top level, ma'am, firstly he's involved in a lot of hard work, ma'am. And thereafter, once he reaches that level of efficiency, thereafter he need not do that much hard work, but he involves himself in quality training sessions, and ma'am, that is smart work, ma'am.
See your PIQ that you have been good athlete, cross country, hockey, and so on. So, what an athlete or a defense aspirant, you know, should do to improve his or her performance in this physical fitness, yes, or
yes.
Say in physical endurance when it comes to physical endurance, yes.
मैम फर्स्टली देर आर टू मेजर थिंग्स. फर्स्टली देर इज रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ प्रॉपर कोचिंग मैम. लाइक इफ सम लाइक इफ कोच इज देयर मैम ही विल बी एबल टू गाइड द एथलीट बेटर बिकॉज एवरी वनस बॉडी हैज डिफरेंट फंक्शनिंग मैम. मैम बट इफ समवन हैज सम पर्सनल कोच सो ही और शी माइट बी एडिक्वेटली गाइडेड बाय द कोच मैम. एंड अनदर थिंग विच कोच ओनली माइट सजेस्ट इज द डाइट प्लान्स मैम विच ऑल्सो बिकम्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इफ वी इफ समवन वॉन्ट्स टू परस्यू द एथलेटिक्स और एनी अदर स्पोर्ट एट हायर लेवल मैम. सो दीज टू थिंग्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड अलॉन्ग विद दैट मैम द प्रॉपर फॉलोइंग द शेड्यूल दैट इज बींग डिसिप्लिन्ड एंड रीचिंग फॉर ट्रेनिंग ऑन टाइम एंड गिविंग 100% एफर्ट एवरी टाइम वी एंटर द फील्ड. दीज आर सम ऑफ द थिंग्स विच anyone must do to reach the top level मैम.
I can see that you have done the paragliding as well. You have a exposure of paragliding also.
Yes, ma'am.
So, tell me few important rules for paragliding.
Ma'am, firstly, whenever we fold up glider, ma'am, there are 3 to 4 ways through which we have to fold. We just cannot fold it any way we like. There are many ropes. So one way is that we hold the ropes together and we form a mushroom. That is one way of packing. Another, ma'am, there are many cells in the glider. So another way of folding is going cell by cell. This is one of the rule. Another rule is that, ma'am, whenever there are many lines, ma'am. So we need to keep in mind which line to pull, ma'am, and which line not to pull. So these are the two main rules which. We have to keep in mind while doing paragliding.
Okay. Now coming to defense forces part, especially the Indian Army, I would like to know about the recent military exercises being conducted by the Indian Army. And can you name a few of the Army operations? Yes.
Ma'am, firstly, the recent exercises. Firstly, there are two main exercises which are going on. Firstly, on 23rd and 24th of June, the Indian Navy and the Indian Air Force, they had held exercises in the Indian Ocean with the US Navy, where the USS Ronald Reagan carrier striker group was there. And from India, the Indian Air Force and Indian Navy participated, which included INS Kochi, P-8I aircrafts, and also Sukhoi Mark 30. And another which happened between the European Royal Navy and the Indian Navy, in that they had also included the navies from Italy and Spain, ma'am. So these are the two major exercises which are going on. Some of the major operations which have been taken by the Indian Army is the Operation Pavan, Operation Cactus, and also Operation Meghdoot, Operation Vijay, ma'am. So these are some of the major operations which have been undertaken by the Indian Army.
Tell me about the basic organization structure of the Indian Army.
Ma'am, firstly, there is section, ma'am, and three sections combine to form a platoon. And after...
Can you tell me from the core, right from the headquarter level? Yes.
So, ma'am, firstly comes the commands, ma'am. Mm-hmm. And thereafter, they are divided into different cores, ma'am. And the corps are thereafter divided into various divisions, which are subsequently divided into many brigades, and brigades which are further broken down into battalions or regiments. And after that comes company, platoons, and sections, ma'am.
Okay. Now, can you tell me about the internal disturbances which has been happening in Pakistan? A neighboring country. What are the internal disturbances in Pakistan? Can you name few?
Yes, ma'am. One internal disturbance in Pakistan is regarding the recent issue in Afghanistan, ma'am. As the US forces are withdrawing from there, ma'am. And but US forces at the same time had asked the Pakistani government for having air bases out there. So that just to keep a check if Taliban tries to regain or tries to spread violence again. So this was one of the thing, and another issue internally in Pakistan is the issue of terrorism, ma'am, and because of which the economy is not able to grow, even though many organizations have stepped up and have been eagerly trying to help Pakistan in for their infrastructure development, but the economy has but the money has been funded to terrorism, ma'am. So these are the two major internal issues in Pakistan.
See, what do you understand by line of actual control?
Ma'am, in the year 1993 and in the year 1996, there were two Sino-Indian talks which had taken place. And ma'am, before that, whatever disputes had taken place between India and China, it was basically regarding that China did not consider the McMahon line because they said that it was drawn between erstwhile British India and Tibet. So thereafter, after a lot of conflicts had taken place, then in these two talks, both the countries came on the same table and had talks saying that they will consider LAC as a legal line and will not indulge in doing any activity beyond that towards the territory of other country. But ma'am, there has been problem that there is no clear demarcation on it, on the ground and neither on the map. So that's why although we had talks, but still conflicts have been arising over the years, ma'am.
Okay. Supposing you are a newly commissioned officer and you have been given a project, right? And you have completed halfway the project and suddenly you realize that you have committed a significant mistake in the project, okay, and you had to restart the project. That is the only option.
Yes, ma'am.
Right. So, what will be your next action since that is the unit's project? Yes.
My next action would be to firstly, with my team who is working along with me, I'll firstly note down the mistake which I had done, ma'am. So that I make sure that I do not repeat them again, and thereafter I'll organize my team, and by putting in some extra efforts like working for some extra hours, and I'll be able to work on those mistakes, and I will finish the task in time. Yeah.
Okay. Tell me today's two national news. To international news.
Yes, ma'am. Firstly, the national news, ma'am. The Gupkar Alliance, which had talked with the PM Modi, they have told that they will agree on the delimitation process, and also our honorable Prime Minister, he had told that this will lead to the development of the democracy structure in the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. And ma'am, second national news is that. Recently, the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs, ma'am, which is headed by the Prime Minister, they have told that the subsidy on the agricultural products will be increased by 140%. And ma'am, two international news. The first international news is that New Zealand became the first country to win the ICC Test Championship by defeating India in the final. And the second news is regarding the vaccination, ma'am. There has been a new variant of COVID which has been discovered in India. That is the Delta Plus variant, which is also known as AY.1 or B16172.1. So, ma'am, these are the two national and international news.
In your opinion, what is the impact of coronavirus on Indian economy?
Ma'am, India is a country full of cultural diversities. So, ma'am, one major sector which has attracted lot of people from outside and even domestically was tourism. So, ma'am, tourism was hit greatly because of which the economy had suffered a lot of loss. And after, in the first wave, when the nationwide lockdown was there, all the industries and major industries were shut down, because of which the production had got down. And thereafter, we see in the second wave that the prices of the commodities have risen. So this, these are the major impacts which the COVID has given to Indian economy.
Right, Chandraprakash, we have come to the end of the interview, and now I'm going to debrief you regarding the interview.
Yes, ma'am.
See what points I have observed. That when I asked you, like, what happened in your previous SSP?
Yes, ma'am.
Right, you told about the psychology, what you did in the psychology, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, plus the other reasons you said. You should avoid saying about the, you know, your performance in the psychology. Instead, you should focus, you should tell about on the lighter aspects.
Yes, ma'am.
Right? And what I noticed that you tried your best, right?
Yes, ma'am.
But you need to be lively as well.
Yes, ma'am.
And I can see that you are hardworking, you are sincere. I can see it throughout the interview. And when I asked you what preparations you have done, you told about all the preparations. Right.
Yes, ma'am.
You said that I have attended coaching.
Yes,
in
ma'am.
Lucknow. So you should have named the coaching as well. Right?
Yes, ma'am.
See, you are joining. You want to join the Indian Army, right?
Yes, ma'am.
And you are serious about it. You have done your schooling from RAMC, and you really want a career. So there is, you know, you can always say, you did everything, you left no stone unturned to make it this time.
Right? Yes, ma'am.
And yes, I, in the interview, I could see that you were, you know, rational, and the content part was also good enough. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
But there is always the scope of improvement, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So what I advise you to be consistent when it comes to your, you know, knowledge updation. Your GK part,
yes, ma'am.
Both national, international, and the defense awareness also, right?
Yes, ma'am.
And I also observed that you should listen to the questions. Though you tried your best, it was one odd question, you know.
Yes, ma'am.
The focus was shifted. But yes, overall, you have performed well, right?
Yes, ma'am.
But you know, you should, what I advise you for the future and for now, that, you know, keep on with your preparations.
Yes, ma'am.
Right? And go with the balanced approach, right? And the areas, now you have, you know, what are your, you know, the areas where you need to improve on, and what are your strengths. But now you know it.
Yes, ma'am.
Being here in the academy. So work on those areas, right?
Yes, ma'am.
And practice.
Yes, ma'am.
So this is going to help you out in your performance, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So the practice is a way out, because through practice, you will be perfect.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay? You will be the best.
Right? Yes, ma'am.
So all the best for your future endeavors. Thank you. You can leave.
Thank you, Adam.
हेलो फ्रेंड्स, मेरा नाम सागर चहार है.
मेरा नाम आयुष शुक्ला है.
मेरा नाम रवि प्रकाश यादव है.
माय नेम इज विक्रांत साहू.
एज यू ऑल नो, आई गॉट रिकमेंडेशन फ्रॉम एफएसबी गांधीनगर.
हाल ही में मैंने इलाहाबाद के 11 एसएसबी बोर्ड से इंडियन आर्मी में रिकमेंडेशन प्राप्त की है.
आई गॉट रिकमेंडेड फॉर एनडीए 145 कोर्स
एंड आई गॉट रिकमेंडेड फ्रॉम 11 एसएसबी इलाहाबाद.
आई गॉट रिकमेंडेड इन नेवी 10+2 बीटेक एंट्री.
आप भी बन सकते हैं हिस्सा भारत के रक्षा क्षेत्र में हमारी ऐतिहासिक कामयाबी की दास्तां का. क्या आप भी बनना चाहते हैं अधिकारी भारतीय सेना में? अगर हाँ, आज ही ज्वाइन करें सेंचुरियन डिफेंस एकेडमी और ले इंडिविजुअल एंड पर्सनलाइज्ड गाइडेंस इंडिया के इलाइट एसएसबी पैनल से.
अगर आपने सेंचुरियन डिफेंस एकेडमी के YouTube चैनल को सब्सक्राइब नहीं किया है तो अभी सब्सक्राइब करें और बेल आइकन दबाएं ताकि लेटेस्ट नोटिफिकेशंस आपके पास सबसे पहले पहुंचे।